Hi, I'm George Pearson, and this is a tutorial video for Adobe's Photoshop program. You'll find links in the description for any materials used in this video. And of course, don't forget to subscribe, like, and also share the video. I really appreciate that. Okay, let's go ahead and get into the video. In this Photoshop tutorial, I'll show you how to paint a house, and not just that, but to paint a house to match a swatch. So here's our basic house, and let me show you this effect once we have painted the house to match our swatch. There we go. There's the swatch right there. So it's fairly straightforward. The two parts really is just to create a proper mask for this and then to get the color over here for your swatch. Let's talk about the first step first, and I'm just going to hide this. What you'll do is you'll take your image, and we're going to make a layer mask by making a careful selection around the front. Now in this case, what we need to do is to make a selection for the front of the face. It would be across here and down around the edge here. Now when I made my selection, I used the Refine Edge tool to get a clean selection around the edge of the bushes in here. And then you'll want to remove the windows out of that selection. Just real straightforward selection stuff. I happened to use the polygonal lasso tool over here and add and subtract to get the elements selected, and of course the refine edge option up here, refine mask option to clean up around the bushes. Let me just bring that up. I went ahead and saved that selection. There we go. So there's a selection that I made. You can see what I did was I first selected the whole house like that. I then came in and removed the windows from the selection, all different windows, and then I came in with a refine edge tool and cleaned up around the edges of the bushes. And that left me with that nice selection. That's probably the hardest part of this part that's going to take the most time on this particular video, is to go ahead and come in and make that careful selection. Now the more time you spend on this, the more careful your selection is, the better the final effect is going to be. So don't scrimp on this one step. Once you have the selection done, you're then going to convert this into a layer mask, which you'll be using on another layer. Now if you're using the refine edge, you can at this point go ahead and save this to a new layer with your layer mask already taken care of. In this case, I don't have that, so let's just grab the background here. I'll make a new layer out of the background. Try that one more time. There we go. Here's our background layer. And let's do a layer mask for this. At the very bottom down here, we have the button for layer mask. And there we go. That just makes a layer mask of that layer. Or you can go up to layer and make your layer mask from in here. So two different ways then of creating your layer mask. Once you have that, click over on the image side of this new layer. Make sure you see that white outline around it. That lets you know that this is the selected side. And we're going to desaturate this layer. So image, adjustments, and way down here, desaturate. It just makes it a black and white image. Now notice, because of the layer mask, we're only seeing the black and white or gray tone in this area in here. All the rest is still remaining in color because the layer mask is blocking the rest of that out. We're just seeing this section. Okay, so far so good. Now we need to create a new layer. So make a new layer right there. It's a new layer button or layer, new layer, like that. We now need to fill this layer with some color. So I'm just going to hide that layer, come down to our background layer, and I'll grab some of the blue in here just off the face of this house. So come over here, click on your foreground color swatch, and you can then just click anywhere in here, and that gives you that color as a swatch. Choose OK. And then paint bucket. Come back up here to the new layer, and just click in here to fill that new layer with that color. Okay, now we have this with some basic color in here. We now need to select our color. We'll do that over here. Now I have another file over here. This is simply a scan of a paint swatch. And then I have a couple of layers in here that were actually taken from that paint swatch. There's one swatch just by itself. There's another one just by itself. And we can use those to then copy the color from this paint swatch over onto our other file, onto this layer. Let me show you how that's done. I'll go up here, we'll take a section of this top color in here, make sure I'm on the right layer, background layer, and grab the polygonal lasso tool, make sure you're on new selection, and I'm just going to click inside this and just grab the color inside of this area. So I just want to have just the color in this selection, nothing else. Let's now make a new layer of this. So it's layer, new, layer via copy, and there's our new layer. I'll double click here and then just name this to match. This one is named Cozy Corner. There you go, that's that name right there on that. So there's our color swatch. Once you have your color swatches separated out onto their own layers like this, you then can use those to copy over to our other file. Let's see how that goes. Now leave this file open and come back over here. So you have two files. Now we have our original image file right there, a new layer which we filled with the color from the original background image, and our other file, which is our paint swatch file with our layers set up. Go up here to Image and Adjustments, and right down below Desaturate, we have Match Color right there. Click on that. Now ignore the top part, we're not doing this. Just come down here where it says Image Statistics, and we have Source. In here I have my paint file, our image. This is the house image, and then the paint swatches image down below. Now on this one, here's our paint swatches, and there are the layers. There's the one we just did, Cozy Corner, just like that. And there's Blue Strata and Blue Edge, the three different colors that I had in there. Let's say I'll do the Blue Edge color. And again, these are the different layers that we have. There's the background layer from the swatch, and these are the other three layers that I showed you in there. So choose one of your layers, choose OK, and it simply changes the color of this layer over to the color that we had on this. This happens to be this one right down there. It simply changes, you know, it takes this color and it fills this layer with that color from that swatch. So that's how you can copy your colors over very, very easily. Now that we have this, I need to get this color onto that image. So we're going to be blending this color down. So go up here to normal, I'm blending just the color, so come way down on our blending modes, down towards the bottom is color. We've now colorized the whole picture, obviously, so I want to have just the front of the house colored, and that's where we made that color mask. We're using this for two things. The layer mask in here, I'm using it for showing the black and white image, the desaturated image, just that one area, and also on the color. So hold, click down here on that layer mask, hold the Alt key down, drag up. That copies that layer mask up, and there we go. It's now copied onto that layer. Now you notice that the color is not an exact match. First, of course, there's a lot of variation in here on this wall, so I have to just kind of ignore that, but it's also too bright, and you'll find that you'll need to do some value adjustment on your color to make this work. Actually, the value adjustment is going to be down here on your image so that this looks correct. Let me show you how that's done. Go up here to Layer, and we're going to be doing an adjustment layer here, new adjustment layer. And we'll use the levels. And right there where it says use previous layer to create clipping mask, just check that and choose OK. And there we go. Now I want to just darken my midtones down on my black and white image. And that's this middle control right here. Pull it to the right, it darkens the midtones down. And just pull it over until you have a good close match to that color. It's not going to be exact on this because there's so many variations in here on that paint, obviously, you know, darker and light spots all over the place. But we can adjust this so we have our values about the same. And that then gives us that look of this house painted with that color. Let's just close it down. So there you go. That's how you paint a house with a color. Now, if you want to change the color, just make another layer for your color, copy it off from another swatch, and copy in that layer mask, you know, the Alt and drag. Let me show you that. I'm going to hide these. Let's open up our other group. Here's this same set. I used a different color in there. As you can see, this is a little bit darker on this one. And I have a yellow in here. So here's my black and white image. And then we're seeing our background down there for all the color stuff elsewhere. Black and white image. There's the layer mask. Here's our adjustment layer to control the values of the desaturated image. And let me show the yellow right there. This is just the yellow on top of that. Again, layer mask here as well. Now this is coming in too dark, as you can see, so we need to lighten this up to make this match this. So we come down here to the adjustment layer, double click on the icon, that brings the controls back up again, and then slide the middle control over until it's about the right value to match your color swatch. That's all you have to do. So right about there looks pretty good to my eye for a good match on that. So there it is. The adjustment layer allows you to adjust the values of your black and white layer, and that lets you match the values of the image to the value of your paint swatch. And that's it. That's all you need to do to paint the color, change the color of your house. There it is. That's painting a house inside of Photoshop and matching it to a color paint swatch. Thank you for watching this special Photoshop photography project video. Don't forget to subscribe so that you will get first notice of new project videos in the future. Just click on this link right here where it says subscribe here. You can get all 12 project videos in this series, along with 26 special videos demonstrating the tools and techniques that I used in these projects by clicking on this link right down here. And then thank you again for watching this.